On this week's Essential API of the Week, we take a look at secure storage, which is a great API to store strings securely. So tune in. Welcome back to another Xamarin Essentials API of the Week. Today we're taking a look at secure storage. Now, this is one of my favorite APIs because it is sort of the extension to the preferences API. But with preferences, we have this kind of key value store of storing arbitrary data like booleans, integers, and strings, but these are in the open. They're clear text, if you will, that are saved to disk. When you need to store things like OAuth tokens or usernames, you don't want to put them there. You want to put them into secure storage. Now, what's great about the secure storage API is that it uses the keychain and key store on both iOS, Android, and Windows as well. So this means that your credentials or anything that you're storing in secure storage is encrypted on disk, which is super nice. So let's see how we can integrate it into our app. Here we are on the Xamarin documentation page where I get started every single time with Essential API of the Week. And when you're on Xamarin Forms, Android, or iOS, you're going to see Xamarin Essentials. When you tap on that, you'll get all of the documentation you need for Xamarin Essentials and all of the APIs here. Now, there is a great getting started guide, which will guide you through installing the NuGet packages and any additional setup that you may need. And specifically on Android, you're going to need to add a little bit of initialization code and permission support to ensure Xamarin Essentials is set up. Now, inside of secure storage, this is a more complex API, so there is a little bit of additional setup to use this API that you need to be aware of. So here, make sure, of course, read that getting started guide. For Android, there's a little bit of information to understand how secure storage works with auto backup. We guide you through enabling and disabling auto backup. So if you want those secure credentials to go between uninstalls and new devices and different devices, you'll want to either enable or disable. I prefer to do this selective backup, which enables us to filter out just the secure storage and nothing else. So there's a little bit here. It's not required, just recommended. Now be aware also on iOS, there's a little bit of keychain authentication that you need to set up when you're in simulator mode. And on UWP, nothing else to do. Now I do love this API because it's super simple. Check this out. When you want to set an item in the secure storage, you set async. Give it the key and give it the value that you want to set. Now it only takes in a string because that's how it is encrypted on disk, but you'll have it right there. The other nice thing here is that you can also say get async. Now this will return a value or possibly could throw an exception if that's not supported on the disk, so you want to use that there. And that's it. You can also remove, you can say remove all. And you can even learn about the different implementation details, because again, this is a little bit more of a complex API. But let's integrate this into our app. Our app here is this little login app, and previously we've used preferences to save usernames and preferences, but nothing for this password yet, because that would be a little bit weird to put in preferences and not recommended. We want to put that in secure storage. So here on Android, what we're going to first do is we're going to go into our NuGet package manager, and we'll install Xamarin Essentials into all of our apps and libraries. So here I've already installed it into Android, iOS, and my .NET Standard 2.0 library. So I have access to those underlying APIs and the abstraction. Now here inside of main activity, I have my initialization code and that request permission that we saw from the documentation. So what we're gonna do here is when we go to log in, whenever we log in successfully, that is when we'll want to save that password into secure storage. So here's my handle click event where I'm checking internet access and making sure that the password is strong enough. So here, what we'll go ahead and do just for this demo purpose, we'll go ahead and clear out the information when it is valid. And what we're gonna do as long as it's valid is we're just gonna set this into secure storage. So let's go over and actually just copy and paste the code from the documentation. So we'll hit copy, come over here, and hit paste. Now we'll just call this token, because that seems pretty okay. And then what we'll also do is we're gonna say password entry.txt. So whatever that password is, we'll save it right into storage. We'll add a breakpoint here just in case something goes wrong, but it's all right. And then we're going to go ahead and get it. So we'll go ahead and hit copy the get code. Now this is asynchronous, so there's async await. So we're going to want to put this in a place where we can handle that. So we can't really put it in our constructor, but we'll put it in our onAppearing. So we'll call this override async void, and we'll go ahead and get that back. And again, this will be the token. So here we'll go ahead and now say password entry.text equals OAuth token. Or in this case, we'll just call it password. There we go. So now what we'll do is we can come in and add a breakpoint here and hit debug. Now the first time we launch it, we shouldn't have anything into our token since we haven't set it yet. But the next time we launch it, we should get that password back. So we'll give it a second to redeploy. There we go. We've hit our breakpoint. So we'll go ahead and continue. And what we'll see here is that the actual text value is null. There's nothing set on it at all because that's what our password was set to. So now what we'll do is we'll go ahead and let the page load and we'll enter our password of test1234 and hit login. Now this will go ahead and save it to the secure storage part of Xamarin Essentials. Now all we need to do is quit the application. We'll go ahead and launch it one more time. So now we're in a new debug session, but we've saved it into secure storage. So what we ideally will see is that now our password field will be 1234. There we go. We've hit our breakpoint. Our text is currently null. And as I step over, we can see now that it's set to 1234. The difference is that with secure storage that's been encrypted to disk, it's not going to be crackable at all, and it's stored in the keychain and key store on both iOS and Android. There you have it. With just a few lines of code, secure storage is updated and into our application. That is just one of many APIs of Xamarin Essentials, so be sure to read the documentation in the links below to learn more about the amazing library that's available to you as a Xamarin developer. That's going to do it for this Essential API of the Week. Thanks for watching.